Hello everyone, thanks for watching this video. So in this video today we are going to understand how to delete the middle element or middle node of a singly linked list. Okay, so something like that of a singly linked list, but the question is that the singly linked list would be odd singly linked. Odd list singly linked means a singly linked list where number of node is odd. Suppose that a singly linked list which has 3 node, a singly linked list which has 5 node, 7 node, 9 node, like that. Okay, so our responsibility is to delete the middle element from the or middle node from the odd singly linked list. Okay, assume that we will be getting one singly linked list, something like that. Okay, if you see here we have total 2 4 6 7 7 node is there. Okay, and our responsibility is to delete the middle node. After deleting the middle node, okay, middle node, so if you see the middle node will be 3 this side, 3 this side, 48 is the middle node, means the fourth element of this singly linked list where size is 7. Okay, so if you see after deleting the singly linked list we don't have the 48. Okay, so our responsibility is to delete the middle element of a odd singly linked list. Okay, so in order to delete the node we have to perform following task, but before that, if you are directly jumping to this program, you always have a chance to watch the program number 6 from the same playlist. Okay, so that will give you the better understanding while directly jumping into this program. Okay, so let's start now. Now first we have to design the algorithm. What are the things we have to do? First task is always create the singly linked list. Okay, after creating the singly linked list, second task is to load the data. Okay, and third task is to make a connection of node. Okay, after making the connection we have to write a logic to display the singly linked list, just to make sure that we created singly linked list correctly. Fifth task is, if you see here, deleting the middle element is fine, but the singly linked list should be odd. Okay, to identify which singly linked list is odd or which singly linked list is even, okay, we have to get the size of the singly linked list. Okay, then get the size of singly linked list. Okay, after getting the size we can easily understood that, okay, this is the even singly linked list or this would be the odd singly linked list. So finally we got the size. After getting the size, okay, identify the middle node, means if the singly linked list is having 7 node, so we have to identify which one is the middle. So fourth one is the middle. Likewise, if the size is 9, so fifth node or fifth element will be the middle node. So we have to have another step called identify the middle logic. Identify. Okay, after identify the middle node, we have to delete the middle node. Okay, after deleting the middle node, we again have to display the singly linked list, just to make sure that the node got deleted successfully or not. Okay, good. So we have to do from first. So first task is to create the singly linked list. And we know how to create. We will be having one private inner class. Okay, private class. Okay, called list node. Okay, good. Static class. Okay, inside we are going to declare two private variable. One variable is the data, which is integer type, since I am going to create the linked list as a integer type. Second one is the reference of the next node. Okay, so reference of the next node, which we are calling as a next. Okay, good. After doing these things, we have to initialize these two variables, and to initialize we are going to use here constructor. Okay, call public. Here we are receiving data as a input. Okay, this dot data equal to data. Okay, and this dot next equal to null, since by default the reference of the next node is null until unless we have to do the linking or we have to make a connection. Okay, that is good. Now we are good with the first task and we are done successfully. Okay, second task is to load the data. That we will be doing in client, means main method. Okay, good. So let's copy from here to here, since this all the task has to be happen from client side. So let's copy here. Okay, load the data. Load the data means nothing but we have to create the instance and we have to pass the data. Okay, first equal to new list node. Okay, good. So if you see here, we are going to load the data something like 18, 28, 38, 40, something like that. Okay, so let's copy paste. Okay, so first data is 18, second data is 28, third data is 38, 48, 58, and 58, 68, 78. Okay, good. 68 and 78. Good. Now so we created total 7 node. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, first node is also called as a head, so better to change head. This one is second node, this one is third node. Okay, this one is fourth node, this one is fifth node, this one is sixth node, this one is seventh node. Good. Okay, so let me show you the PPT also. If you see here in this diagram, we have to delete the odd, we have to delete the middle node from the odd singly linked list, and we having our same singly linked list something like that, where we have the total 3 plus 3 plus 1, means 7 node, which has the data called 18, 28, 38, 48, 58, 68 and 78, where 18 is the head, means first node, whereas 78 is the tail, means last node. After deleting the middle element, middle element means fourth position node or fourth position element, so which is 48. So if you see, this could be the our output. This is expected output. Okay, and that we are trying to achieve through our Java code. Okay, so we are done with the second task, which is loading the data. After loading the data, our third task is to make a connection, means establish the connection between each node. So head means first node, I am connecting to second node through the next, means reference variable equal to second. Okay, and second dot next I am connecting to third, and third dot next I am connecting to fourth, and fourth dot next I am connecting to fifth, and fifth dot next I am connecting to sixth, and sixth dot next I am connecting to seventh. Okay, and seventh is the last node, so no need. So basically we are done with the connection also. Okay, now our third task is to check whether we created correctly or we made a connection correctly or not. So for that we will be having one method called display, means we are going to perform a task for display. So let's create one method called display, which is our fourth task. Okay, inside the display we are going to pass argument as a head, means first node, since we are going to traverse from first to last. Okay, so similarly we are going to create the display method here. Good. After creating the display method, we are receiving link list from the user, or we can say head also initially, but good to say that it's link list. Okay, name could be anything. So as soon as we receive the user input, we will be having one local variable which hold that data, means link list coming from the user. Okay, so the value name is current. Okay, local variable name is current. Now we are going to traverse link list through the while loop from first node to last node. Basically last node will tell you I am null, that means reference of the last node is null, so we should not go till null. Means once we met the null, we understood that okay, we are done with the traversing. Okay, that's the reason we are checking here null. Okay, means our node should go from first node to last node. Okay, good. Since we are doing the display, so we should have one SOP also. So this is the node, okay, where we will be having data. Okay, and from one node to other node we will be having one separator also, that looks good. Okay, and I want to print all the node into the same line, so no new line required. Good. This is the data from the first node. Then I have to do the movement from one node to another node using current equal to current dot next. Okay, so this will give you to move from one node to another node. As soon as I am coming out of this loop, means we understood that okay, we met the last node, so it's our responsibility to print the reference of the last node also, which is good. So we are done with the display. Okay, so which is our fourth task, means fourth task done successfully. Let's run just to verify. Okay, run a Java application. If you see 18 28 38 48 58 68 70, means we created singly linked list successfully. Good. Good. So fourth task is successfully done. Now fifth task is to get the size of the singly linked list, since this task will help you to get the middle element to identify whether this singly linked list is even or odd. Okay, in order to get the size, we again have to create one method called size. Okay, here we are going to pass argument as a head only, means linked list only, and we are going to create accordingly the method. Okay, good. So we receive the user input here, and we are going to create the local variable just to secure this one, and local variable name is current. Good. So basically size is nothing but also one, we have to traverse from one node to another node, and we have to capture the movement. Okay, so as soon as movement word will come, means we are going to move from one node to another node. For that we need while loop, and while loop has to travel till last node. Last node means it should not meet the null. Once this met the null, it has to come out of the control, out of the loop. So this while loop will help you to reach the last node. Good, since I am checking not null. Now it's both the logic is same, only display and size. Only thing is that here we are going to display, but in size we don't need the display, only we are just doing from movement from one node to another node, which is good. Current equal to current dot next will give you the movement. So what I'm trying to do is, as many times I will move, I'm just keeping one counter here, counter should increase by 1. Okay, counter equal to counter plus 1 or counter plus plus, both are fine. Okay, and let's define initialize int counter equal to 0. Good, so we will be having one while loop which is traversing from one node to another node. For each and every traverse we are just capturing the movement, means capturing the occurrence into the counter variable that we initialize as a 0. And after coming out of this while loop, so this counter contain all the number of movement. So I want to return this counter, since it has the only value which will help me to get the size. So instead of white, I should be returning int. Okay, so good. Now good, so let's have one int size. Okay, let's have an SOP here saying that size of singly linked list is, what is size? Okay, good. Now right click, run as Java application. You see size is 7, 2, 4, 6, 7. Okay, means size of singly linked list is 7, which is good. Means we are also done with the fifth task. Okay, now the real task is came, which is to identify the middle element. Okay, so how we are going to identify? So let's have one if condition here. What we are trying to do is, if this size what is getting returned from the singly linked list is M% 2 does not equal to 0, is does not equal to 0 means the singly linked list is odd, means size, if size is not divisible by 2, means obviously it is odd, simple, odd and even. So in that case, int index equal to, I want the index from where we are going to delete, right, means middle element. So in that way, means element from where we are going to delete is size divided by 2 plus 1. Okay, so this will give you the size. Okay, so just assume that we are getting size as a 7. Okay, size divided by 2 means 3, 3 plus 1 4th, that's why we want to delete the 4th. So this formula will help you to get the middle index. Good, now what I will do is, good, now here I am going to pass what I will do. Okay, good, fine, here only I will be writing a logic to delete, or else not good. Let's have it here in index equal to 0. Let's declare one global variable. This looks basically good. Okay, good now. Okay, so instead of writing everything in if condition, I have just decoupled the code, nothing much. Okay, so we identify the middle element, okay, and that is available into the index. Good. Now delete the middle element. To delete, we are going to write a logic here. So logic is very simple, delete. So here we are going to pass two arguments. First argument is the linked list from where we are going to delete the element, and the second argument is index, which will help you to get the middle element. Okay, and accordingly we are going to create the delete method here. Good. Now as soon as we receive user input, we know first task we are doing is we are securing the user input. So for that we will be having two temporary variables. First variable is called anything we name, we are writing here as a previous. Okay, second is that index means position from where we are going to delete. Good. Now what we will do is, we know how to delete, since in previous program we already covered how to delete the element from the various place. This is specific to middle element deleting. Okay, so we will be having one while loop, since while loop is only helping us to traverse from one node to another node. Okay, in while loop we are going to traverse from one node to another node. So something like that, previous equal to previous dot next. Okay, this will help you to traverse. So how many times I will traverse, I will be having one counter variable, okay, which is integer type. Int counter equal to 0. 0, no, 1, since head is already there. This is the head. So this start from second onwards, that's the reason counter I have started from 1. Okay. Now what I am telling is, now we are traversing, that is good. Condition is from where we have to traverse, how many times we have to traverse. So counter is less than index minus 1. Why? Because in last program I have already explained you, if you want to delete the element 48 in this condition, so we should not reach to 48, we have to reach the 38 only. Means if you want to delete the element from the fifth position, you have to target the fourth position first. If you want to delete the element from sixth position, you have to target the element from the fifth position. Means one step or one node ahead, okay, or sorry, one node before. Okay, so this is the only logic you have to understand while deleting the any node from the any of the single linked list. We should not direct target the element which you are trying to delete. We have to target the element which is one node before. Okay, good. That's why I am traversing till index minus 1. Good. Now as soon as coming out of the while loop, okay, means we reach the we basically reach 38. Okay, so for that, if you do something like that, means I got the 38. So 38 I have to secure current equal to previous dot next. Okay, so for your understanding, if you print one SOP here, current dot data. Okay, so before running this program, you have to tell me the answer with yourself. Okay, just pause this video and get the answer. Okay, then I will understand you got the flow of this program. Okay, okay, let me run this one. If you see here, you will be getting 48. Okay, our responsibility is to remove the 48. So here this previous actually has the 38 only. If you print one SOP here, means previous dot data. Okay, so we will be getting 38 only. See, 38 only means as soon as I am coming out of this loop, I have the 38 here, and after moving one step ahead, I got the 48 here. So let's have this one is your 38 and this one is your 48. Since I am just doing the movement, that's why current dot data is 48, or else the data is still 38 only. As I told you, we have to target the one element before while deleting. Good. So we got the 38 anyhow, not required. Our main logic is here to get the 48. Now what we will do is we will replace the 38 to 48, I mean 48 to next node. Okay, so to replace, how we are going to replace this previous dot next, I am replacing with current dot next, means the next element, and after replace, as I told you, the data is still there. It's our responsibility is to make it null so that memory will release. Okay, probably you will be confused here. So not to be confused, you just have to print the this one current dot next dot data. This will help you to get the data as a 58. Okay, dot data. So tell me what would be the data here. It should be 58. Since 48 I am replacing with the 58, that's all. You see 58. So this current dot data is your 48 that I am replacing with the 58. So previous dot next, previous dot next means 48. This one I am replacing with the 58, and the 48 I am making as a null. 58 I am making as a null just to release the memory. Good. So why this? Okay, here is the index. Okay, good. So good, now we are able to delete. Just to make sure that we are able to delete, for that we are going to use the display method, and for display the logic is same only, no changes required. Okay, now let's run this program as a Java application. If you see, we are, our target element is to delete the 48, and we don't have 48 here, means we are able to delete the element successfully. Let's remove this 3 SOP here. So this SOP I am commenting it. Okay, this SOP I am also commenting it, and this SOP I am also commenting it. Okay, good. So let's have one more SOP. What is that? This is the single list I am deleting. Okay, let's have one SOP here saying that before deleting the middle, middle, middle element from singly linked list. Okay, and here you can say that after, so this will be more understandable. Okay, good. Now if you right click run as Java application, you see before deleting this one is the our link singly linked list, and after deleting 48 is not there, so we are good now. Okay, we are able to delete the element, middle element, successfully from the singly linked list. Okay, now let me summarize you again. So our task is to delete the middle element. To get the middle element, we have the singly linked list called odd. Okay, in order to delete the singly linked list, first task is to create the singly linked list. After creating the singly linked list, we have to make the connection. Okay, which is our second task. Sorry, we have to load the data. After loading the data, we have to make a connection. This is our third task. After making the connection, we have to write a logic to display. Okay, means our connection and the data loaded successfully. Okay, once display done, then we have to get the size of the singly linked list. Okay, depends upon this size, we are going to identify our singly linked list odd or even. This program is only talking about the odd singly linked list, we are not talking about the even. Okay, we will be having program in queue which will basically help you to, this is the 13 number program where we are deleting the middle element from the odd singly linked list. 14th, we are going to delete the middle element from the even singly linked list, and 15th is the consolidate of the 13th and 14th. Okay, so good now. So this code will help you to identify the whether your singly linked list is odd or even. Depends upon that we are getting the index value. Once we get the index value, we are start deleting the element. So this logic will help you to delete the element. Delete the element means replacing the one node to the other node, and where we are targeting the one step ahead. This is the one concept while deleting the element. After deleting the element, we have to display the singly linked list just to make sure that the singly linked list got deleted successfully. And once done, we will be getting this output, which is as per expected. Okay, thanks for watching this video.